Thank you so much, President, for those words. As we proceed, I would like to also acknowledge the presence of our chairman of our technical department, technical committee, Dexter Skeen, former national player as well. And as we go forward, as President mentioned, the technical committee has been hard at work over the last few months as ensuring that things are measured out in the right way for our various national teams. So allow me to list for you the members of staff that will be working alongside Mr. Latapy on this national under-17 team. We're going to have Mr. Latapy as the head coach, Reynold Carrington as assistant coach, Nigel Neverson as the goalkeeper coach. Our physiotherapist will be Otis Hislop. Then we have Devin Elcock as the kit manager, and Alexandria Elliott Prokop as the manager of the team. And of course, the two coaches who are being retained for a transitional period are both Kyle Small and Dwayne Richardson. On that note now, I'd like to call to the podium, of course, again, no stranger to us. He's been a darling of local football for so many years. We're going to allow him an opportunity to voice his opinion and share his thoughts on his new appointment, Russell Latapy.
Good day, everyone. I've represented Trinidad and Tobago football for over 3 decades, you know, and it's been a passion and a love of mine. Speaking to David over the past few weeks, you know, I wanted to have the opportunity to come back home and share some of the knowledge and experiences that I've gained over the years. So this is a perfect opportunity for both parties, the association and myself, in working with some of the younger players and passing on some of the tricks of the trade in professional football and international football that I've gained over the years. You know, I had the opportunity to have a look at the players, you know, and it stresses the feeling that I have that we always have a lot of very talented young players in this country, and one of the problems that we've had in the past is these young players getting the right guidance from an early age. I am here and with the support of this association to try and provide the guidance and opportunities for some of these young players to move forward in football and have a career in football, and not only become better footballers, but become better young men and better men in general. And I look forward to this task, and I can guarantee everyone in this room and in this country that I would continue to do my best to make this country proud and to produce fantastic young players and fantastic people. So I look forward to this job, and I thank in advance the association for all the support that I've gotten so far and the continued support that I look forward to. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Russell. As we proceed, allow me to give you some minor details on the upcoming tournament, which begins September 16th and runs until September 25th. There are going to be two groups of 8 teams, Group A and Group B. Matches are going to be played at the Atto Boldon Stadium and the Hazley Crawford Stadium. Kicking off on September 16th, Trinidad and Tobago's opening game is against Haiti, and then we play Jamaica on September 20th, and we close off the group stage against Bermuda on September 8th. We play Bermuda on September 18th, and then we close off the group phase against the Jamaicans on September 20th. From these two groups, the top 5 teams will advance to the CONCACAF final round, which will be played in Panama in 2017, April 21st, starting in April 21st. And then, of course, the top 4 teams advance to the FIFA Under-17 World Cup in India 2017. If I may just recall as well, the last time a Trinidad and Tobago Under-17 team played in the final round in Panama City back in 2012, we missed out on qualifying for the World Cup by just one single victory, losing our final game to the host country by 4-2. And, of course, I'm sure many of us now are looking forward to us going a step further this time around.